we are going to discuss another problem on array fill series. So here we are going to construct one magic square. So this problem is very common and very popular. So what is a magic square? So let me go for the next slide. So construct a magic square having dimension n cross n, where n is one odd number and n is supplied by the user from the keyboard as input. So if the value of n is 5 has been supplied, then the matrix will have the size 5 cross 5. So now here the number will be ranging from 1 to 25. So the first number will be 1 in the middle column in the first row. And always we shall try to move in this particular direction, in this way. We shall try to move in this way. So from 1, the next number will be 2, which is not within the logic, not within the limits. So 2 will be here, 3, 4 will be here, but this is outside of the limit. So I shall be coming down here, 4, 5, 6 will be here, but it is preoccupied. So I shall start filling 6 from here, 6, 7, 8, 9. It is outside of the limits. So 9 will be here, 10 outside of the limits. So 10 will be here, 11 is preoccupied, it is filled up with 6. So it will come down here, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, it is outside of the limit. So 16 will come down here, it will be filled up there only. 17, 18 is outside of the limit, 18 is here, 19, 20, 21 it is preoccupied, so it will come down to this 21, 22, 23 is here, which is outside of the limit, so 23, 24, 25 will be here, so it will be coming down to this level. So here it is 25. So it is a very complicated logic to fill up this magic square. And in this case, what will happen if you fill up this magic square, all the row wise sums, all the column wise sums and diagonal sums are equal to each other, and here it is 65. So this is the problem of magic square. So I have given you sufficient number of hints that how to solve this problem. So try to pause the video here, try to solve the problem yourself in C programming. Otherwise, the demonstration is there where we shall discuss each and every logic and how to implement the same in C programming, that will be demonstrated. And also the magic sum will be calculated directly from n before filling up the matrix. So how to get the respective logic of the magic sum involving n? So here is the demonstration for you. Please watch.
Let us discuss the logic with you once again. So the question was, construct a magic square having dimension n cross n, where n is odd, so that is mandatory. The value of n will be supplied by the user. Okay. What is a magic square? Magic square is a square matrix which will be filled up with numbers ranging from 1 to n square. Each will be used once, and its row wise sums, column wise sums and diagonal wise sums are equal to each other, and the sum thus obtained is known as magic sum. And in the second part of the problem, it has been asked that find out the expression for the magic sum directly from the dimension value n. So this is the problem. So now you know that this is the matrix fill up logic for magic square if the dimension of the matrix is 5 cross 5. So here the magic sum is 65. Why the magic sum is 65? If you go on adding any row, if you go on adding any column, if you go on adding any diagonals, one of the diagonals, then you'll be getting 65 here. Here the value of n is equal to 5, which is an odd number, and that's why 5 cross 5 matrix has been formed. So how to fill it up? The logic is something like this one. So it will go in this way diagonally, then come down, then it will go in this way, then come down, then it will go in this way, then come down, then again it will go. So at first, the first data, that is 1, will be placed at row number 1 and column number 3. How to get column number 3? In case of 5, how can I get the middlemost number 3 in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? That is very simple. That is n plus 1, that is 6, by 2, that is 3. So here we'll be having row is equal to 1 and column is equal to n plus 1 whole by 2. That is the initial value for row and column. So here the row is equal to 1 and column is equal to 3. So 1 will be placed here. So just consider this fill up logic as we told you. That is, 2 will be coming down here, but 2 is going outside of the range because it is going to put its 2 where the row number is equal to 0. So 2 will be coming down here according to this, then 3 will be coming down, then 4 will be here pointing, but it is outside of the column. So here we had row wise folding and here we will be having column wise folding. So 4 is there, 5 is there, and this is a preoccupied logic because after filling up 4, then 5, then when I'm trying to fill up 6 here, but the 6 place is preoccupied, so I shall come down for, I shall increase the row number for 2 and then I shall decrease the column number by 1, then I shall come to this place. So 4, 5, 6 will be here, then for filling up 6 I shall come down to this place, then 7, then 8, then it is going to 9, 9 is here, so 9 will come down here, then it will be 10, 10 will be coming down here, it is preoccupied, so it will be coming down for, it will be coming down for 2 rows and then 1 column, and then 1 column decremented, then 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Now here we are getting the corner logic. That means if you go on folding column wise, if you go on folding row wise, then also you are remaining outside of the array range. So after 15, 16 will be coming down here, then 17 should be there, but it is going beyond the column number. So 17 will be coming down, then it is beyond row number. So 18 will be coming down, then 19, then we'll be having 20. It is preoccupied. So 21, 22, it is going beyond the column number. So 23, 24, it is going beyond the row number. So 25. In this way, the things are taking shape. So now we are going to implement the same logic in our coding and see out of 1 to 25, because when the value of n is equal to 5, then the numbers will be ranging from 1 to 5 square, that is 1 to 25. The middlemost number is 13. And here you see the 13 has been placed at the middlemost place. So how to get 13 from 5, how to get 13 from 5? It is very simple. That is 1 plus 25 whole by 2. So 1 means 1, 25 means 5 square. So 1 plus 25, it will be 26, by 2, it will be 13. So 13 will be the respective middlemost number. And here you see the magic sum is 65. How to get 65? It is also very simple, that is 13 into 5. So how to get the magic sum? The magic sum can be obtained with the formula like this. Here you see, if the value of n is equal to 3, then the magic sum we are getting 15. If it is 5, then magic sum we are getting 65, as we have observed already for 5 cross 5 matrix. When the n will be 7, then in case of 7 cross 7 matrix, the magic sum will become 175. So the logic will be n squared plus 1 whole by 2 will be the middlemost number into n, that is the dimension, you are going to get the magic sum accordingly. Okay, now let me go through the logic. How can you fill up this magic square accordingly? So initial r will be 1 and c is equal to n plus 1 whole by 2, which we discussed earlier. Here r is denoting the row number and c is denoting the column number. So you see, whenever I'm from 13 to 14, when I'm going, actually row number is decreasing and column number is increasing. Row number is decreasing and column number is increasing. So my default logic will be row minus minus and column plus plus. That is r minus minus, c plus plus. So that will be the normal fill up logic. In the following conditions, fill up will be turned. You see here, this fill up logic will turn its head. That means I'm just telling in this way. So when I'm having 1 here, then 2 will be here, but here I cannot put 2 here. Why I cannot put 2? Because here the row number has become 0. So this is my row wise folding, so I shall be putting 2 here. Similarly, in case of 24, when I'm going to put 25, then the row number has become 0, because before 1 the row number will be 0. Then I'm putting this particular 25 at the row number 5, that is n. So row folding logic is, if row number is less than 1, also I can write row number is equal to 0, then row number is equal to n. So that is our row folding logic. Now let us go for the column folding logic. So after 16, if I want to put 17 here, then you see the column number is getting 6, which is more than 5, which is more than n. So when the column number is greater than n, then I shall go, so here I shall go to the first column. So the logic will be, if column number is greater than n, then column is equal to 1. So that is my column folding logic. So already we have discussed row folding logic, we have discussed column folding logic. Okay, now see, in case of corner, so after 15, the 16 should be placed here, but here the row number is equal to 0 and column number is equal to 6. So row number is equal to 0 means less than 1 and column number 6 means more than 5, more than n. So in that case, what we shall do? We shall increase the row number by 2 and we shall decrease the column number by 1. I think you are getting my logic. After 15, the 16 should be filled up here, but it is going for beyond the range. So it is known as a corner folding. So here, from the row number 0, I should come to the row number 2. How 2 can be obtained from 0? By adding 2. And how can we get 5 from 6? Because 6 is the column number here. How to get 5 from 6? That is 6 minus 1. So if row number is less than 1 and column number is greater than n, then row is equal to row plus 2 and column is equal to column minus 1. So in this way, that is my corner fill-up logic, corner logic. So we have discussed row folding, we have discussed column folding, we have discussed the respective corner logic. Now, we are having the last logic, that is a preoccupied logic. What is a preoccupied? Here you can find that after having this 10, when I was supposed to fill up 11 here, but 11 location is preoccupied. So if we have shown this one earlier, that if we define one array in a global scope, that means before main, like this one, if we define one array before main, then all the locations will be filled up with zero values. That we have shown that one. Okay, now see, while putting a certain value, if I find that the location is not filled up with zero, that means it is preoccupied. So after 10, when I'm supposed to fill up this location by 11, I'm finding that this location is not having a zero. That means it is preoccupied. Then what should I do? From the row number 3, I should come down to the row number 5 like this. And then from the column number 2, I shall come down to the column number 1. So how to get 5 from 3? That is 3 plus 2. That is row number plus 2. How to get column number 1 from 2? So that is column number 2 minus 1 will give you the 1 as a column number. So the preoccupied logic is, if A or C is not equal to 0, then row is equal to row plus 2 and column is equal to column minus 1. So in this way, this is the preoccupied logic I'm finding here. Now, question is coming in the mind that in which order I should put all these if blocks in my code. So if statements are to be written in which order? So should I go for the limit check at first or should I go for the preoccupied check at first? I think limit check should be done at first. Why? Because if I'm outside of the limit, then there is no logic to check whether the location is preoccupied or not. So limit check should be the first check, whatever we should do, and preoccupied check should be the second check, whatever you are supposed to do. So I'm labeling it as case A and labeling it as case B. So out of these four different situations, this preoccupied logic will be coming at the fourth check. Now, what about this? We're having row folding, we're having column folding, we're having corner logic. Which logic has to be placed at first? See, the same condition, that is row less than 1, I'm putting here. This column greater than n, I'm having here. So this is my, if we consider this one as condition 1 and this one as condition 2, here we are having condition 1 and condition 2. So my opinion is that I should put this condition at first. I should check this condition at first, because if this condition is true, then both are true. So if I put this row folding or column folding prior corner logic, then they will get satisfied and corner logic cannot get the control. So that's why my opinion is that I should put this particular check at first, because they are involving those two conditions which we are having in our row folding and column folding connected by AND logic. So I'm putting this condition as condition number 1, and I can put them either in the condition number 2 or condition number 3 or condition number 3 or condition number 2 in any order. So my first condition will be the corner logic. Second and third condition can be row folding or column folding, whatever required. And the fourth logic will be our preoccupied logic. In this way, the problem should be written. So now let me go for the implementation through C. So here you see, here we are having this, that we are having this row, column, n, s, and the respective I. Please enter the odd dimension of the matrix. So I have taken this n as input. So here I didn't check whether the user has put the odd number or not. That you can implement here. You can go on adding some code here to check whether user has given the number of the number of that is a dimension of the matrix odd or not. If he or she hasn't given, then I shall have to ask him or her again to provide the dimension of the matrix. So now I'm going to calculate the magic sum before filling up the matrix. The logic is very simple, as I discussed earlier. So now row is equal to 1 and column is equal to n plus 1 whole by 2. So that is our default logic. That is our default logic. So row is equal to 1 and column is equal to n plus 1 whole by 2. So for I is equal to 1 to n square, you see here I put less than equal to. So that means 1 to n square will be the range with the help of which the array or the matrix should be filled up. So A R C is equal to I, and the default case is row minus minus and column plus plus. To maintain this logic, row will be decreasing and column will be increasing. So that's why row minus minus and column plus plus. So I've done that one. So now I'm putting the corner logic at first, then I'm putting the row folding, then putting the column folding, then I'm putting the preoccupied logic. So from in the here, you see everything is in one screen, so you can easily check. So this corner logic I put at first with the respective actions to be taken, and then I went for the row folding, then column folding, and then preoccupied check. So in this way the array has got filled up. Now I'm just printing this array content accordingly, and I'm just calculating the diagonal sum. That means I'm calculating 17 plus 5 plus 13 plus 21 plus 9. What is the logic? Logic is that when row number and column number are equal, that means you are dealing with the diagonal data. So if row number and column number are equal, you are going for sum is equal to sum plus ARC. In this way, the sum is also getting calculated. So the calculated sum I'm printing here, and obviously before filling up the matrix, the pre-calculated sum, magic sum, has got printed. So now let me go for the execution at first. So I'm just clicking on this compile and run. Let me put this one under comment. So I'm going for this compile and run now. So here the dimension was 5. So let me give 5 and check whether the matrix is getting filled up accordingly or not. Yes, it is 1 row folding, 2, 3 column folding, 4, 5 preoccupied, 6, 7, 8, row folding, 9, column folding, preoccupied, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, corner logic, 16, column folding, 17, row folding, 18, 19, 20, preoccupied, 21, 22, column folding, 23, 24, row folding, that is our 25. And here the magic sum I calculated prior was 65. And now I have calculated the magic sum, that is 65 again. So in this way, the problem has got implemented. So let me check for 7, whether the magic sum is 175 or not. So I'm putting the value 7 here. So we are getting this 175 here also and here also. And that is a fill-up logic. And you see, when we are having 7, that means the numbers will be ranging from 0 to 49. The middlemost number will be 25, and that has been placed at the middle. And then 25 into 7, you are getting this 175. So let me go for the last one, that is for n is equal to 3. What happens? Let me check. So I'm just clicking here. So I'm putting here 3, I'm pressing enter. So you see, we are having this one, and the magic sum is 15. So the magic sum is 15 accordingly. And here you see, the middlemost value is 5. So numbers are ranging from 1 to 9. The middlemost value is 5. So 5 into dimension 15 I'm getting here. So in this way, this problem has been solved. Please leave your comments, leave your issues, if you're having any doubts, if you require any clarifications, in the comment block, so that we can give you the answers accordingly. Thanks for watching this.